on this Father's Day, if I were to start at the 14th verse just for your notes and for your understanding of the context, Mother Craig, this is Mother Hope, this is Mother McAllister, this is the time in which Jesus and three of his disciples, apostles, Peter, James, and John, and Mother Cooper, Sister Gracie, they had had a rousing good time. The Lord had blessed them up on the mountain. He even said, it's good that we're here. With his knife told himself. He said, let us build a tent. You know, they were having a good time. With something that they'd never seen before. Jesus being transfigured. And Moses and Elijah, who they thought was long gone, appearing on the mountaintop with Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Have I got a witness?
Spirits, demons,
Straightway the Spirit tore him, and he fell on the ground and wallowed, foaming at the mouth. He did this so many times during this same chapter that it's mentioned that he did the same thing two or three times. That's just what kind of halt the demons had. Amen. Look at 21. And he asked his father, how long is it ago since this came unto him? Now tell me, Brother Mantell, is there any reason for Jesus to ask the question, how long? Don't you think that Jesus would have known the answer? That was a right answer. Well, why would he ask the question like that? Only so you could see, and I could see, and the crowd could see, that fighting crowd that was arguing with the nine disciples and apostles that had been left down at the bottom of the hill, so that they could see what a glorious God and powerful God.
Yeah.
He's not going to just tackle something that happened yesterday. He is going to actually have to tackle something that has been with the boy.
Right.
Since birth. People have been ignoring the boy. Just say nothing can be done.
Yeah.
People that look at you and me and say, well, it's been 8 years.
All right.
And if it hadn't happened, it won't happen. They look at you too. And say, you had all this time and you still don't have no money in your pocket.
All right.
Like me. I wish I got three or four more amens. Thank you, Sister Mary. People are looking at you and me right now, and all the Christian races that are, yeah, you join church, and you in the church, but you don't seem to be any better or doing any better than me. So Jesus asked questions so the crowd would know. This child has been three things. He's been suffering from what is called, in that time, the falling disease. Secondly, the child was a lunatic. Thirdly, the child had evil demons. Now, Pastor, what does that have to do with my understanding of the context? I'm glad you asked the question. Is that this story is a story that is given in Mark 9 is not to be confused with the graveyard person in which he withdrew the legions from. Neither is it to be confused with Mary Magdalene, in which he took the seven devils out. This is a unique and a untold story of what Jesus does when people think there's no hope. Because, and I hope that you'll write this down, the disease in which I've just described from the scripture, he did not have epilepsy. Jesus had. He had a disease that when it came upon him, it hurled him. I wish I had somebody. Without him even showing any signs of having any problems, when the demon came and landed in him, it lifted him up. And if that was a body of water, it threw him in the water. If there was some fire around him. So the individual didn't set himself on fire with this disease. He was thrown into the fire. Never got rid of it. The person didn't go for a swim. He was thrown in the water. Never got rid of it. And for your context and your understanding, is that you got to recognize that whatever the condition is that seems to be something that God can't cure,
Yes, sir.
He can do it.
Amen.
Lift up your heads, all you gifts, and know that God can bring us through.
Yes, sir.
Stop shaking it with me. I ain't never seen nothing like this. Well, this scripture I just described, you've never seen anyone impaled such that he was picked up wherever he was and thrown into the fire or water. Are we good with that verse?
Yes.
Because I'm almost through.
All right.
Look, and then he said, how long? And then the 22nd verse. And oftentimes, it had what? Cast him into the fire and into the waters. What was the objective? But if, can somebody walk up on the stage and underline that if? Do you know who he was talking to? If thou canst do anything. This father was so concerned with his father, with his child, and with his son, but having all of this this particular ailment, is that he was probably thinking, if I could use my mind, if you can just keep him from the spirit from just putting him in water. If you could just keep him from the spirit putting him in fire, I'd be pleased. Have I got a witness? But I want to tell you, Father, after God, after Jesus, I've been waiting on you to come down from where you were, because I've been talking to your church folk. I've been talking to your disciples the night that you were left here. So I did. apostles anyway. Yeah. If you read the 14th verse through the 20th, you find out that the Father said, I brought him to see you. Right. And how did I know that? Is that the pronoun is capitalized. The Father said, I brought him to see you.
Yes, sir.
And these apostles said, bring them on over here. Sit them down. But nothing was healed.
Right.
He continued to have the same problem. 23rd. But Jesus said unto him, I'm going over to the whole of my you know what? I have been reading my Bible closely.